Thank you. It's English. actually. Apparently. Yeah. They say it's English. I'm going to dedicate this next three songs to them. I'm going to play the accordion, the banjo, and the triangle. But I don't know what order I'm going to play them in. Y'all, what do you want me to start with? Which way do you want the pain? You want it the worst, the fast?
Oh, Lord have mercy.
I love this style. Give it a round of applause for my friend from Manchester over here. Come on. Come on.
All right.
You thought I was joking, right?
No, I didn't.
No, you didn't, huh? Yeah, I'm serious. Boy, I'm serious. Yes, over here. Yeah. Okay, we're going to start with the triangle. Now, let me tell you a funny story. I play up in Canada at them folk festivals, you know, the Vancouver Folk Festival, and they noticed me. They said, wow, you're talented, right? And they said, you want to play a song on the closing night? I said, I sure do. And so, what are you going to do? I said, I'm going to play a triangle. And they said, well, no, sir, you don't understand, because they thought I didn't know, you know, and, like, you know, wasn't that smart, right? Said, you don't understand, it's closing night. The biggest crowds will be there, man. You don't want to play a triangle. I said, no, man, I want to play triangle on closing night. I got me a standing ovation. The song I played was by a Canadian songwriter named, who's very dear to my heart, good friend of mine. His name is Bruce Coburn. And he's written songs about people, the human condition, and the environment, and Native American injustices for as way back as you can go. And here's one of his songs about the Native American thing here, from from Saskatchewan, Ogallala, you know, to Pine Ridge, to Leonard Peltier, you know, Ghost of Adamant, you know. Huh? Here's a little triangle for you. When's the last time y'all heard a triangle play? Well, that's too long. Down in Louisiana, my grandfather said, you just bang on that triangle and watch your feet, and you'll know who your relatives are. You know? That's right. He said, or get out your fiddle and play a little tune for them. My family was French. They taught me accordion and violin. I'm going to play the accordion next, if y'all want. What y'all want me to play after the triangle? Banjo or accordion?
Banjo.
Accordion.
Banjo.
Man, it's tying right now.
Accordion.
Ah, it's leaning over towards accordion.
Triangle.
I just got a tweet from Donald Trump. He said accordion. He said, there's no one more Mexican than me. It's going to be great. Fabulous. Wonderful. And there's some other cliches. And it just dribbles off into what? Nonsense. Jesus. Oh, God. Sorry I gave that guy my number. Here's a little triangle for you. Y'all really want to hear the triangle? Because I was joking the whole time. Are you sure? Give me a round of applause. Yeah. All right, I'll play triangle for you now. From the Arrondissement. To hang out for me, history of betrayal continues to today. Parts of the manuscript, parts found of me. She called like thunder from the mountains. You can hear her say, it's stolen land. All we got, stolen land. Like it or not, it's stolen. had this famous quote. He said, "I'm not sure, I'm not positive, but I'm pretty sure all music comes from New Orleans." And how great that was. Great Ernie Cato. Y'all know him. Yeah, you do. I know you do. Just don't know you do. How great thou art, Ernie Cato. I had a call from a girlfriend of mine in New Orleans once said, I sent her down there. I gave her some directions. I said, go over here. And she went down there and called me up and said, Al, I'm standing next to this little big guy, and he's telling me such stuff you wouldn't even believe. Said he rode with the Queen of England, got 25 gold records, and he's floated on clouds, you know, all this. You should check him out, he's a crack up, little bitty guy. I knew she was talking to Ernie, right? I said, darling, I think that Ernie Cato you're talking to. And he said goodbye to her. And when he got up to leave the bar, everybody in the bar took off their coats and their nice coats and whatever they had, and they put it on the floor for Ernie to walk out of the bar on top of their clothes because they don't want his feet to touch the ground. New Orleans, you know, we honor our people the best we can. I'm gonna take you outside of New Orleans right now. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, I want to get you guys playing music before you all leave, so let me train you guys. Hey, y'all, everybody here pretty good on eating? How about you? Can you slow down for a minute? How about you? You're on salad, man. Of course you need to slow down.
Thank you.
Yeah, take care.
Yeah, this is easy.
I just made them. You want to play these?
Yeah. Kurt needs one. This guy needs one.
Oh.
And our other friend just got his
shit. Right now.
Yeah, yeah, buddy. Yeah, buddy.
I'm going to lose my job, dude. So, what we got is oh, this is going to be great. Everybody in the house, how about you, Stafford? You want an instrument? Don't run away. Grab on out of there.
I don't know if I've got time for
this. No, it's all right, man. I'll lend you some money when
I'm
you get fired.
I'm going to fire him now.
Are you going to fire him?
Yeah.
How about you? You want to play an instrument?
No.
No? That does it. Now I'm really upset.
Well,
all right. This can be great. I love when people walk into the restaurant about now. They walk in to order some food, and everybody in the restaurant is playing a musical instrument, and they're like, oh, Lord.
What? Huh?
Oh, this guy doesn't have one either.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to sing a song about the Great Wall. The Great Wall. Actually, the song was written years ago. It's called Alien by Gil Scott-Heron, and it's about people that come to America from Mars that don't have green cards. Called Alien. Give it a little shake, everybody. Come on now. Don't be sluggish. Come on. Give it up. I give it to you now. Give it to me.
Diamonds on the water, so they
you wanna hold on to your dreams. Hold on. Then I feel love holding on. Just add water. Yeah. use words like droughts, because there's a reason why those trees live on fog, not rain. They sound dumb.
Back, man. good enough.